Hello, welcome to SS UniTech, Sushil this side, and this is continuation of SSIS tutorial. So today we gonna discuss about change data capture with incremental load. If you haven't watched last video of this video series, so I would strongly recommend to watch that video before going forward, because where you can understand about the change data capture with initial load. So what is initial load and how we can implement initial load? Before move to SSDT, let's have a look of SQL Server table. So this is our source table which we have used in our last video, and this is our destination table. So in our last video we have loaded this source data to destination. Now we will load data on incremental basis. If we will insert few record on this table and then we want to execute our incremented package, then only those records will be moved to in our destination table. If we will do some changes on this existing data, then that data would be updated in our destination table. If we will delete any data from this source table, then in destination table we are having a flag column that is deleted, that would be replaced by true. So go to on SSDT to implement the package. Here let me create one more package, then call this package as CDC incremental load. That is fine. Now we have to use CDC control task. This is for start and this is for end. So here I wish to rename this with start and this is for end. So I would like to change with end. That is fine. So in between these two CDC control tasks, I would like to use a data flow task. So we can drag and drop data flow task as well. So before going to configure all these, let me create connection managers. So first I would like to create new OLEDB connection manager and then call this as source. Next I would like to create one more OLEDB connection manager and this is for destination. So let me rename with destination. Then I would like to use ARIO.NET connection manager for this CDC control task, because CDC control task accepts only ARIO.NET connection manager, and call this as CDC. Nice. Now I need to configure our CDC control start. So double click on this, and as we can see SQL Server CDC database ARIO.NET connection manager, that is CDC, because in our connection managers we have only one ARIO.NET connection manager, that is CDC. So here we have by default CDC. Now in CDC control operation I would like to use get processing range this time. So here I don't have any variable which will store the CDC state. So let me create a new variable, CDC state. Nice, click on OK. Now so table to use for storing state, that is CDC state table. That is fine. So we have configured CDC control task start. Let me configure CDC control task end. In our SQL Server CDC database ARIO.NET connection manager, that is CDC. That is fine. In CDC control operation I would like to use mark processed range. In our variable let me select CDC states variable. That is fine. And in our table I would like to use CDC states. That is fine. Click on OK. So now we have configured our CDC control start and end. So we can connect with start, then data flow, and data flow with end. Now let me concentrate on data flow task. So double click on this data flow task. So here I would like to use our source. So that is CDC source. So we can drag and drop the CDC source. Then double click on the CDC source. As you can see ARIO.NET connection manager, that is CDC. That is fine. Okay. Now in CDC enable table, as we can see we are having employee source, because in our database we have enabled CDC for this table only. That's why we are going to get this table in this drop down. So we can select. Then in CDC processing mode I would like to change with net. In our variable let me select our CDC state variable. That is fine. Go to on columns. So I am happy with all these columns and click on OK. Now we have done our source. Let me configure our transformation. So here we need to use a transformation, that is CDC splitter. So we can drag and drop and connect with source, and there is nothing to do with CDC splitter. It will divide our inserted, updated and deleted record automatically. Now let me configure our destination where we want to load our incremented data. So we want to load in SQL Server table. So we need to use OLEDB destination. That is fine. Let me connect with CDC splitter. So it will ask what output we want. So this time I would like to select insert output. That is fine. Click on OK. Double click on this OLEDB destination. And here let me select our destination table. Employee destination. Go to mapping. Mapping succeed. And enable is deleted, as we can see ignored, because we have specified default value for this is deleted, that is 0. So this will be inserted. Now click on OK. So this is our OLEDB command transformation. So I would like to use for update and second for delete. Let me rename this with update, and this is for delete. So let me rename with delete. Now go to our CDC splitter and pick this data pipeline and select with update. So here this is for update, so we can select our update output. Click on OK. And third is for delete, so we can configure our delete. Now I would like to configure our update OLEDB command. Here we need to select our connection manager, that is destination. Looks good. Go to on component properties. In component properties we need to write our update statement. So update, then we want to update our destination table. That is fine. Then we want to set value for EMP name with anything. Second is salary, anything. And we have department ID, so that is department ID with anything. And we want to update where EMP ID is anything. Now click on OK. So we have done our SQL command. Now go to on column mapping. So in column mapping, as we can see, we have available destination and available input columns. So we want to map with parameter 0 to employee name, second parameter 1 to salary, and parameter 2 for department ID, and then for employee ID. That is fine. Click on OK. So we have done our update. Next, move to our delete output. In delete output, we don't want to actually delete the data from destination table. We just want to update the is deleted flag. So here go to on SQL command. Let me write our update statement. So update, and we want to update our EMP destination table. So this is our EMP destination. Then we want to set is deleted column with 1, where EMP ID is anything. Now click on OK. Go to on column mapping, and our parameter 0 should be mapped with EMP ID. Now looks good. Click on OK and save our package. So go to on SSMS, and here I would like to insert some record. So I would like to insert 11, name is Neha, then salary something, and department anything. And we want to insert one more record, name is Shiv, and we are having salary anything and department anything. So as we can see, in our destination table we are having only 10 rows, and in our source table we have 12 rows. So our package will be executed, then these 11 and 12 will be inserted in our destination table. And here I would like to update some record. So let me update Howard with Howard fight. That is fine. And let me delete one record, that is employee ID 8. So once our package will be executed, then 11 and 12 will be moved to our destination table, and our ID to our employee name from Howard to Howard 5 would be updated. And for ID 8 in our destination table, it will be replaced false to true. So go to on SSDT and let me execute this package. So as we can see, we are getting 4 rows from our CDC source. Then after CDC splitter, it will divide 2 rows for insert, one row for update and one row for delete output. So go to on SSMS and here I would like to refresh this destination table by pressing Ctrl R. So here as you can see, we are having Howard fight as we were expected, and in our ID 8 Jaydeep we are getting true, that is also fine. And for insert, 11 and 12 have been inserted in our destination table. So I hope you have understand what is CDC and why it's required and how we can do the initial load, and here we have understand about incremental load. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of our newly uploaded videos. Thank you so much.